there's a lot of you.
Hi. So my name's Jack Grant. I don't know why I said that. So why all the Radiohead propaganda? That's a great question. Thanks, Kirk. A few months ago, my roommate Ethan convinced me to listen to this podcast, the Dissect podcast. Any Dissect podcast fans in the crowd? It's great. I don't know. Now we know who the dorks are. So it's a music theory podcast. Basically, they take music by Radiohead, Childish Gambino, Tyler the Creator, a lot of really popular modern artists, and they go through in depth what each of those they go through each album and they talk in depth about what prompted a decision by the artist, maybe some interesting music theory thing that's happening in the background of the song. And so I listened to, the very first season that I listened to was the In Rainbows season, Radiohead's In Rainbows. And at the end of the season, it was Reckoner, was the song that they were dissecting. They talked about the full idea of the album. They get to almost the end of the album, and they're talking about what the idea was, and about the idea that if you're in a rainbow, you can't touch it. You can't. It's not tangible. It's not something that you can hold on to. And so, what is a rainbow at that point? The metaphorical rainbow, not the light through a prism. To me, rainbows are goals that we strive for in our life. There are events in our life that are big that affect us deeply. And I've had a lot of those events in my life. I could sit here and talk about them all night, but we'd be really sad afterwards, so let's not do that. So we keep chasing these goals. We keep chasing these rainbows, thinking that we're going to grab them and hold on to them and that we have them forever, but we can't hold on to a rainbow. We can't. So that's what this recital is about. The first half is talking about those rainbows. They're examples of them. And you might interpret them different than how I interpret them. That's why I'm not going to talk about what they are to me. Hopefully you can figure them out for yourself, for what they are to you. And then the second half is talking about what those rainbows meant. Without further ado, Chasing Rainbows.
Senza voi vivere non so.
Ma perché senza voi? check.
I always pick up the check. I think it's funny. Who could top or make this comic opera more compelling? You could weave in some deceit to even up the score. You'd have us all on the floor. That would be roaringly funny. Sad enough, my life's a joke that suffers in the telling. Just another hoary chestnut from the bottom drawer.
Yeah.
duets, the point is, I really like singing with other people. That's fun. That's all I wanted to say. And Sam and I have something in common, a nice, tasty treat that that we both really enjoy. Have you ever put butter on a pop tart? It's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a pop tart? If you haven't, then I think you should. I was sitting in the kitchen one day and I was itching to fill up my belly with a piping hot jelly of the best damn treat of the world.
He's talking pop tarts.
And I saw a stick of butter and it almost made me shudder and scream like a baby girl. I don't want a giant penis or a rocket ship to Venus. I don't want to win the lottery. I just want to squat gobble till I'm dizzy and I wobble in a butterfruit butter tart dream. So I put butter on a pop tart. So freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a pop tart? If you haven't, then I think you should. All right, when I gesture to you all, you're gonna say pop tart. Let's try it one time.
Pop tart.
Fantastic. Have you ever put butter on a Pop-Tart? It's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a
Pop-Tart?
If you haven't, then I think it's good. Have you ever put butter on a
Pop-Tart?
It's so freaking good. Have you ever put butter on a
Pop-Tart?
If you haven't, then I think it's good.
Pop-Tart!
With butter! Thank you so much.
Ha ha ha. Let's do it.
There's a patch of sunlight in my room, on the garden where I held you for a moment in June. There was something so sweet about it, and I just guarded, 'cause it made me fall for you.
There's a tree that looks up at the moon, garden where I held you for a moment in June. There was something so sweet about it. I'm holding on to this moment, 'cause it made me fall for you. Made me fall for you. Take me back to the window. Take me back to the door. You'll be right where I left you, sitting on the floor. Now I'm never gonna be alone. Take me back to the window. Take me back to the door. You'll be right where I left you, sitting on the floor. Now I'm never gonna be
find my way back home to you.
Take me back to the window.
Take me back to the door. You'll be right where I left you, sitting on the floor.
Sitting on the floor. Now I'm never gonna be alone.
Never gonna be alone. There's a patch of sunlight in my room, on the carpet where I held you for a moment.
Why am I pulled to you? Does it never feel like I'm finished talking when we finish talking? Why am I pulled to you? And why does it never feel right to not pick up when you're calling? You know me so well, even if we don't know my favorite type of cereal. You know me so well, even though we're both different. different people now. It's stupid, so stupid to miss you like this. I feel stupid, so stupid to miss you like this. I told you to go and you went. Oh, what did I expect? It's stupid, I know that it's stupid to love you. But I can't help it.
I can't help it. Sense, but it feels like a sign from God that I keep ignoring. How do we get to this place we're in? It makes no sense, but it feels like maybe that's God. Probably shouldn't ignore him. You know me so well. Even if you don't know my favorite type of cereal, you know me so well. To miss you like this. I feel stupid, so stupid to miss you like this. Cause I told you to go when you went. Oh, what did I expect?
So it's stupid, it's stupid. I know that it's stupid. But I can't help
in the program, you'll see that the next guest artist that I'm bringing on is all of you guys. So I am a huge fan of Jacob Collier. For those of you who know me, you know I can't shut up about Jacob Collier. So what we're gonna do, Jacob Collier does these audience choir bits in all of his concerts. So we are going to try that tonight. So I'm going to split you up into three groups, and you can stay seated. But once we get to you, once we get to the end of the song, I'll play each note. And don't worry, I will not leave you hanging. I'll make sure you guys are singing the right note before we start doing any crazy moving around and stuff like that. So let's split those groups up. So. Robert, I'm gonna go your group one, everyone from here over, and then Molly, Campbell, Drake, you guys over to Cameron, Carter, and Aiden. You guys are group two, so Molly to there, and then everybody else, you're group three. So hold up your number, one, two, three. All right, cool. This is going to be fun. I'm a little terrified of it, but it's fine. So, when we get to the end of the song, that's you. It's Jack, but I appreciate it. Thanks, bro. All right. Do you guys need to sing like a major scale or anything? Are you good? If it's not in your head by then, just... Thanks, Kirk. My light, my compass star, be my darkness, be my danger, be the strings of my guitar. Little something strong and something true. In your eyes, so dark and open, there's a light that leads me back to you. 'Cause you're not so far away, I hear you say. You'll never walk alone. Singing, don't be afraid of the dark. In your heart, you're gonna find your way.
gonna find your way home.
Group one. In any octave. Group two. Group three.
The chicken wakes up like she does every morning to the sound of her husband's scream. Sat in the dark on the egg she is warming, she closes her eyes and dreams of walking to Memphis, becoming a dentist, anything but this. I mean, she likes her life as a mother and wife, but is that all she is? She stares out the window. The very next morning, the chicken decides to make her escape, get a taste of freedom. She runs out the coop that her life's been confined to, suddenly sees the thing she's only dreamed of. Just up ahead, gophers run through a meadow. Dear Grace, birds sing. Her future is waiting right there for the taking. There's just one thing. The chicken must first cross the road. The road, sea of trees and green and moss, waiting just across the road. The road. The chicken is little. She moves ahead, left, right, left, right, left, right. All of a sudden she stops in the middle, frozen in place by a pair of headlights. It's anyone's guess what then happened next, but most think she died. But I think we ought to believe that she got to the other side. So that's why she did it.
So before I sing this last set, I wanted to thank a few people. First of all, thank you to Professor Tharp for years and years of guidance, advice. I cannot thank you enough for everything you've done for me. Thank you so much. Next, I want to thank, I've got a long list. Eliza. Hi, Eliza. Eliza sat down with me before spring break and worked with the lighting and stuff, and I kind of know, I don't really know how to do it. I couldn't have done it without Eliza. You're the best. Thank you so much. And also our friends in the studio, Calvin, Steve, Becca, thank you so much. You're over there watching. I appreciate you. I'm eyeballing you right now. they work countless hours to make this kind of stuff work, concerts and recitals. And I'm incredibly grateful that we have people like you working in that studio so that things like that can go up. Thank you to you for coming. Thank you. Really, truly. Thank you so much.
Still thirsty.
The green plastic watering can for fake Chinese rubber plant in the fake plastic. That she bought from a rubber man in a town full of rubber plants to get rid of itself. It wears her out. It wears her out. Wears her out. Wears her out. She lives with a broken man, a cracked polystyrene man that just crumbles. He used to do surgery for girls in the 80s, but gravity always wins. It wears him out. Wears him out. him out. It wears him out. And if I could be who you wanted, if I could be who you wanted all the time. From your sleep, the drying of your tears. Today we escape, pack and get dressed before. Breaks loose. Breathe, keep breathing. Don't lose your nerve. Breathe. Can't do this alone. Sing us a song to keep us warm. There's such a chill. Such a chill. And you can laugh, a spineless laugh. We hope your rules and wisdom just that you choke. Let me get back to your arms. Cheap sex and sad films. get back where I belong. I think you're crazy. Maybe I think you're crazy. Maybe. Stop sending letters. Letters always get burned. It's not they fed us on little white lies. I think you're crazy, baby. I think you're crazy, maybe. And I will see you in the so don't get any bigger deals. They're not gonna happen. You paint yourself white and fill up with noise. For what you're doing.
Thank you again so much, everybody, for coming out. This has been an incredible experience to be able to put all this stuff together and to have so many of my best friends, people I love, here to see me do this. So that's, thank you. Thank you so much.
When I'm at the pearly gates, this will be on my videotape. In Mephistopheles is just beneath, and he's reaching out to grab me. This is one for the good days, and I have it all center when I spin away, out of control on videotape, videotape. I can't do it face to face. I'm talking to you.